we're getting in and beginning to edit my animation. I have to start thinking about the poses that I want to create for my bow and arrow. I think I want to have the arms of the bow and arrow really deform and bend backwards to create an exaggerated pose that will create a good sense of flexibility and energy for the movement of my arrow. In animation, we're always looking for these anticipatory and exaggerated poses to give life and energy and movement into something that really shouldn't be. We over-exaggerate, we push it further than it probably realistically would even go to ensure that it's being read correctly by our audience, and these small little movements are being read very loudly and clearly inside the final animation itself. Now, I need to bend these objects back a little bit, and specifically, I want to bend the top and the bottom of the arms of my little bow and arrow here. And there's a lot of control points going on inside this drawing. I don't want to have to go in and by hand move all of these back together. That's going to create some wiggles and some inconsistency in the stroke quality. So I want to look for a different way of manipulating and modifying this drawing to get the result that I'm after. Well, luckily for us, there is the bend tool. Let's just select this part of my mesh. I'm going to go in. I'm in edit mode, and I've locked down the animation layers for the string and for the arrow. That way, I'm only able to go in and grab, with the box tool, grab the points for the object that I want to work with, which is just going to be the top part of this arm, of the bow arm. I'm just grabbing some points. Okay. Now, the real result here is when we fire off the bend tool. And you can find the bend tool over in your toolbar. It's right below the tool that allows us to change the radius of our strokes. And how this works is once you turn it on, you just simply left click and drag inside your scene. However, this is not good at all. And I'm certainly not getting the type of bend that I'm looking for. And did you see how it was bending or where it was bending inside the scene? I see this dotted line that's terminated at a point, but where is that point and how do I control it? I don't want it to bend way out over here. I want it to bend maybe in the handle. Well, thus enter the role of the cursor, the 3D cursor as it's called here inside of Blender. And this 3D cursor is an interactive starting point for many of the tool operations that we find in the application. So we need to be able to modify and enhance the location of this cursor so that we're getting the level of deformation we seek. Let's go ahead and turn on the visibility of the cursor. It's always on. The influence of the cursor is always active inside the scene. However, its visual visibility is not. It's hidden at the moment. If we go into this pull-down menu way up here at the top of our screen, this guy, these are going to be able to change all of our viewport options. If we click on the arrow to get the pull-down menu, right here at the top, there's an option that says show or it says 3D cursor. And if we click on the little box, now our 3D cursor shows up inside the frame itself. And this is what it looks like. I know it's real small and faint. It's right here inside of my computer screen. You may or may not have seen this in other applications or in other sessions inside of Blender. It looks like a little crosshair, a little target, if you will. And this is the 3D cursor. This is the location where our bend tool is evaluating and firing off inside of our scene itself. If I was to go back in to edit mode, I'm just gonna grab a couple points this time. I'm not going to grab all of them. I just want to show you that with the cursor visible, we can now see real clearly, yeah, that the bend tool is using the current location of the cursor to evaluate where that bend is taking place. Well, I want to go in and fix this. I want to change the location of my 3D cursor to somewhere else inside the scene itself. Let's go back into the box selection tool so I don't accidentally mess up my drawing. And let's look at how we can change the location of our 3D cursor. The easy way of changing the location of our 3D cursor is over here inside of our toolbar. The second choice in the edit menu is a tool that allows us to change the location of our 3D cursor. And it's real easy to do so. Let's just go ahead and turn on that tool. And now, simply wherever we left click inside the interface, our cursor will go. We can put it anywhere we want, which is pretty cool. Now, this is a great way to interactively do it. You can kind of left click and drag and change its location. But what if we want some accuracy? What if we want to go in and say, I want to bend at the tip of this arrow right here. Well, let's begin this process of accurately changing the location of the 3D cursor with a selection. I'm going to go into my point selection system and on the tip of the arrow here, oops, I'm still in the cursor tool. Let's go back to my box selection tool so I can grab Yeah, I didn't grab it. There we go. Let's go into stroke selection. Grab that stroke. You know, sometimes this happens when you're working. Get the stop your selection, get it back again. All right, let's try this one more time. Oh, it's because I've locked the... I forgot that I had locked the arrow animation layer inside of my viewport. Now I can select it. You know, sometimes your technology just gets the best of you. Okay, so let's go back into the box selection tool and return to our point selection system. This time, I'm gonna select just that top point. That guy, right there. It's now the selected component inside of my scene, and I wanna be able to accurately move my 3D cursor to that location. I could get close, you know, I could just kind of click on it. That's pretty close. But if we're working with really complex geometry, just simply clicking on it may not give us the level of precision and accuracy that we seek. Let me show you a quick little shortcut here that's pretty fantastic. It involves a pie menu with a keyboard shortcut. And I'll show you what that pie menu looks like here in a second. The keyboard shortcut is Shift S. And this is a pie menu. Now I'm holding down the Shift and S key and all of these on-screen options appear. It's called a pie menu because it looks like a radial little pie. And each one of these choices is a command that we can ask the computer to complete for us. And one of the options that we have down here is cursor to selected. Now watch what happens when I click on it. Boop, there it goes. The cursor automatically goes to that selected component. Let's do it one more time. I'm gonna grab that point. Shift S to get the pie menu, cursor to select it, and you don't have to click on the dot, just put your cursor above it, not the dot, I'm sorry, the command, just put your cursor above the command and then let go with your keys, and then it automatically evaluates and activates that command, which is pretty cool. So that's a great way of producing some accuracy when working with the cursor itself. Now, another thing that we have access to when working with the cursor is the origin point. And the origin point is the center of the object that we are currently working with. If you've ever wondered what this orange dot is inside of Blender, it's this thing right here. This guy. That is the origin point. The origin point is the center. It's the representation of the location of the entire object container, if you will. And this is a known entity inside of our three-dimensional universe. If we were to go over into our properties panel, this little object right here is going to calculate the location, rotation, and size of this object. It saves all of this information inside of what are called our object transforms. Well, since this is a known quantity inside of our three-dimensional universe, we can use this as well to move our cursor around. Now, my cursor is way off screen. I think what I'll do is just grab my cursor tool and put my cursor right here. Let's go back into my box selection set just so I don't mess anything up. And this time, watch what happens. If I hold down Shift S, we also have cursor to, oops, I need to be in object mode. I apologize. I'm in edit mode. The location of the origin of our objects is an object item. I was at component mode. If we do Shift S again, here we go. Now we can do cursor to active. And our 3D cursor goes right to the location of our origin point, which is pretty cool. The larger point here is that we have two different ways of adjusting the location of the cursor. We can interactively do it with the cursor tool and place our 3D cursor wherever we want. In addition, we can also use some defined locations inside of the scene to snap and automatically place our cursor to those areas. We can either use a point on our drawings or the origin point inside of our scene itself. We view the 3D cursor inside of our viewport properties. It's right here in the pull-down menu for all of our 3D properties. It's always on. It's always influencing our scene. It's one of those elements that just because you can't see it doesn't mean it's not doing anything. It's always influencing a number of the tools and the different systems inside of Blender. With its visibility off, check it out. If I were to return to edit mode and select some points again, check it out. The bend tool is still going to evaluate at the center of that 3D cursor. So with a solid understanding of how and where that 3D cursor is going to be influenced inside the scene, let's do this. I'm going to go back into object mode. I have my grease pencil object selected. I'll hold down Shift S, and I want to put my cursor to the active. We should have placed my 3D cursor right here at the origin. Let's just do a good little double check. Yep, it's right there. Good, I like it. Excuse me, I accidentally tumbled and rotated in 3D view. Okay, now when I run the bend tool, let's just grab some points here. Oops, I'm still in the bend tool, excuse me. I'm gonna grab all these points, make sure that my string and my arrow layers are not selected. Now when I run the bend tool, watch what happens. Well, did it move? I might have accidentally hit undo. Yeah, I hit undo on accident. Let's fix it real fast. I'm gonna go back in time. And let's just for this real quickly, I'm gonna put the 3D cursor just manually, so I don't have to jump into object mode. I want it to go right there. That's a good spot. Now when I fire off the bend tool, you see how it's evaluating at the location of the 3D cursor, and I can evenly deform this. Now, one of the things I've learned about working with the bend tool is that where you initially clicked kind of determines the arc of bending on the object itself. You're going to get a different result if you put your cursor kind of way out over here. So if I start here, you can see I get a real wide sweeping bend. If I start my bend with my cursor closer to the 3D cursor, I get a real sharp bend. So the radius of deformation is going to be a little bit different depending on where you start. So let's find a good, comfortable spot to bend. Yeah, maybe somewhere right around in here. Yeah, that's a good place to begin. I like that. That's a whole lot of fun. I'm pretty jazzed with the result that I get, and this is definitely an extreme, exaggerated pose that when animated is gonna show my audience just a wonderful, wonderful sense of flexibility and energy for the movement of my bow.